Hello once again. The new week is here once again. It's another new week. It's another fantastic Monday. And it's Monday, August the 16th, 2021. And here is your Days of Praise Daily Devo episode 448. And it's the next video of It's All About God video series with number 13. We're going to be fearing God for nothing today in this one. Starting with Job chapter 1 verse 9. Ooh, the very beginning of Job. Ooh, hard to get to read the very first chapter or anything from the first chapter. You usually see them in the later chapters. But smash that like button. Comment what you liked about it. Subscribe if you're new. Hit that notification bell so you'll never miss a video. Share the video with your family and friends to help me reach that goal of 1,000 subscribers, and I'll be much appreciated. And I'm down to 995 to go. But that means I have 5 subscribers on my list. I know two by name, and then the other 3 I just don't know. I know one. I've seen the first one. I've seen that profile. But it's not on the list. Number 3 came up. I don't know who it is. And then just like I said, number 5 came up. I don't know who it is. But number 2 and number 4, I do know names. And I know number 2 because he was my roommate. And, Word of Life. My Word of Life roommate. So you've heard me talk about my Word of Life days. So being in school for a whole year. But I should have went. Sometimes I wished I could have went the second year. But then other times it's a blessing that I didn't. Because there's so much you got to do in the second year program that I probably wouldn't have been able to make it. I probably wouldn't have worked out for me. So God told me not to go. So I did. I mean, I would have had a lot of people around me. A lot of familiar faces for me to do that, but hey, at that time, I didn't want to move out of state, because I would have had gone to New York, because the second year program, that's the only place you can go for the second year. You can have first and second year up there in New York, but down here in Florida, you only got 1 year. You can't do second year. At this time, they have not been able to do second year down here yet, but I've heard that they're trying to work it out to see if they can get the second year program going down here. So, which maybe if they do that and my plans have fell through for what I'm wanting to do, I may just kick it on back down and do second year, knock out my second year, and boom, I don't want to worry about it no more. But with that one, I know there's some you have to go on missions trips, and that's something I probably wouldn't be able to handle, leaving the country. And that's something I've never done. So, but I'm rambling on about stuff that shouldn't have been discussed. But I'm sorry. But fearing God for nothing, Job chapter 1 verse 9 says, "Then Satan answered the Lord and said, Doeth Job fear God for naught or nothing?" So Satan's challenge brings up an important question. Why should a person serve God? His question suggests that Job had no real love for God. His righteous behavior was motivated purely by a desire to receive material blessings. And Job's friend Eliphaz, E-L-I-P-H-A-Z, Eliphaz, apparently had precisely the outlook on life that Satan wrongly accused Job of. Eliphaz believed God took no pleasure in human righteousness. He believed the person should serve God purely out of self-interest, and desired that God would reward him with material prosperity. Job 22, 2 and 3, and 23 through 30 is where you find that discussion. So God had created the world such that wrongful behavior normally leads to unpleasant consequences, while upright behavior normally brings good results. Proverbs 12:21. However, Eliphaz was fundamentally wrong. God did take pleasure in Job's righteousness. Job 1 verse 8 and 42 verse 7. So death and suffering are results of sin. Romans 5 verse 12. The first people God created rebelled against him and brought death and suffering into the world. Genesis chapter 3. However, suffering is not necessarily occasioned by a specific sin in the life of the sufferer, as Eliphaz and his two friends seem to believe. So a person who truly loves God would serve him in good times and bad times. In the sin-cursed world, sometimes wicked people prosper and righteous people suffer. But Job recognized the perfect justice awaits the day when the Creator returns to earth. Job 19:25-27. So this is probably the reason Job maintained his faith, even when God allowed Satan to take everything, including his children and his health. You remember that? If you're good on Bible stories, you remember what happened. All the bad things Job had done to him, but he still persisted to believe in God, to follow God, more or less. But Job often spoke rashly from his pain. Find those in Job 6, verse 1 through 5, and Job 7, 11. But finally, yet his declaration of faith in God is a wonderful example for all believers. Though he slay me, yet will I trust in him. And that comes from Job 13, verse 15. So you see there, no matter what trials and tribulations you may be going through, keep the faith in God and he will bring you through it. All for the good. The goodness of his heart. No matter what pain or sorrow you may be going through, keep your faith in God and he will bring you through it. Don't fear him as other people think you would fear him. Yes, we fear God. We fear death. But we praise the fear of death because we know, us Christians know, we will be with God when we die. Amen? So that's all I have for your It's All About God video number 13. Another regular video tomorrow for your Days of Praise video. I'll give you the preview of that in the ending of your Turning Point video, just a little while. So you'll hear what's coming up tomorrow in that one. But your Monday edition of the Turning Point Devo for August the 16th, 2021, and it'll be episode 14. And we're two numbers off because of the way the weekends are going. But we're going to be talking about the gift of God in that one in a few hours. We're going to be starting with 1 Corinthians 7:7. The recommended reading is Matthew 19:11-12. Your turning point is from Sinclair Ferguson. And your daily reading is Jeremiah 40:41-42-43. Your four chapters there. So stay tuned for that. I'll get to that in just a few minutes here, but you'll see that in a few hours. So stay tuned. But until then, I love you. I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it today. Hope you're someone just like Job, who will perceive your faith in God, even though everything may be taken away from you. But you still perceive your faith that God will bring you through it. Amen? And remember, keep on keeping on and trusting God, and he'll keep you safe in all you say and do. And until Until later, peace out. Until then, everybody. Goodbye. God bless. Have a wonderful rest of your fantastic Monday morning. And come back again for your Turning Point Devo in just a few short hours. Goodbye.